Alright.
We are playing My Summer Car again. I'm really hungry, so I'm gonna eat some potato chips.
I'm eating peanut butter in real life.
No, I'm thirsty because I ate potato chips.
Video of your old pants right?
It might be a while. But don't worry.
I am worried. I don't even know if I should bother with my life.
Hey.
Why? Why would you not bother with life if you didn't see this video?
Because I need to know more about that game. You're hiding it from me.
What the fuck? I filled this goddamn bucket up earlier.
Whoa!
Patrick.
What's up?
You have a problem.
I filled up the bucket.
So I can play Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 or Pokemon Sun, which I just picked up.
Play Pokemon Sun just because I'd like to hear a little bit of feedback on how the opening is and if they ask if we are a girl or a boy again.
Oh, well, you'll be glad to know that when someone on my Facebook said had a comment on that, and I won't say their name just because I finally remembered the recording. I'll read it. where was it?
No, it's not very hot yet.
Wow.
Any of your friends that watched this will probably know who said it.
Probably not. I mean, like, it's not like the people watching.
I'm not
going
to rag on them, even if I don't like the thing that they're talking about.
Oh, but you're ragging on people in my Pathfinder game.
You're ragging on people and the people in your Pathfinder game.
No, one of the Final Fantasy videos.
You were shipped here because you're a criminal, you're part of the criminal colony, you can't stop lying. I'm not racist.
Okay.
But being Australian is not a race, it's just like
national. It's not racist. True, I agree.
I always thought that was weird, like calling be like when you call a British person a limey or something. It's not really racist. What do you call it? It's not nationalist either.
Shut up, the hell of you, limey.
Nationalist already has another definition, so.
I guess it's just being an asshole. Okay, so here's what it is. This person said, bloody clever, Dean Freak, good job. And then someone said, eh? And they said, they changed it up. Instead of, are you a boy or a girl? They asked, which of these passport pictures do you want to use for your passport?
Ah.
They kept the end result the same without having to bring gender into the question
directly.
That's
actually a pretty good idea.
I'm shit. Like, yeah, but like also, like, why does it matter?
It doesn't really, but you need to turn me down a little bit.
Turn you down? Yeah. Oh shit, you're coming through the computer?
A little bit.
Me chatty boss.
Just a little bit.
Oh, I'll move my laptop back. That might help. There, that should help.
Okay, cool. Front right, spindle. There you go.
You're a spindle.
You know, whenever I think spindle, though, I always hear, you know, when you think of like a spindle, you think of kind of like a railing, like a long, straight kind of piece of something, don't you?
I think of a Pokemon's.
What?
Spindle!
Oh,
like
you've been like... You're fucking
say,
video games.
I hate that Pokemon said their names in the anime even when I was a kid.
Yeah, we all know you're a hipster.
And I've always hated... No, it has nothing to do with being a hipster. It's the fact that the anime is like just purely for kids, and it, when that shit bleeds into the games, it's like, God, why you gotta make it more embarrassing to play this game?
Well, it's like Pikachu is fine.
Yeah, and that's all they do that's fine, but I do not want all the Pokemon to start just saying their names. It's the most asinine idea of any cartoon adaptation I've ever heard.
Well, do you want them to speak then, like Digimon?
Why don't they just make animal noises like in the games?
Because then they've got to use human voice actors to make those stupid noises.
It's better than saying Rattata.
Yeah, but it's just gonna be like it's gonna be like and just like stupid shitty noises all day.
It's not gonna be that bad, Patrick.
Why do that? I don't understand why just saying your name over and over is somehow more appealing than
at least,
trying to make them just make a normal sound.
Because you can kind of. Humans can put a little bit more emotion into that than they can with like a brr, 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 like angry pigeon noises or something. I don't know. I just think I can't.
You like the idea of Pokemon saying their name.
If it's in an anime like that,
just anything else.
I don't know. I haven't thought about the alternatives much, but I don't mind it because I'm like I don't really know what else they do even. So.
Let's work. This isn't a kid's anime though. This is just what you want, what you like. Because that's what I'm judging it from. I don't want them... Sure, for kids, it works. It's great, it works. But it affects the games into an extent too, which is what I don't like.
Which games has it really been a problem with, though?
Well, because they started introducing it with Pikachu. What if they introduce it any further?
I don't think so. I think it's just because Pikachu is like the straight up mascot for Pokemon it's the only one that'll do that.
That's why. But like, if people had a good reception to it or something, then it might end up getting worse. And also, I don't want Pikachu to say his name either.
What would Pikachu sound like? Like eek, eek, like a fucking mouse or
I
something?
I don't know,
though?
Patrick. But the fact of the matter is, if you want a living creature that just says a name over and over, then I think you've created something for 3-year-olds.
Yeah, I mean, it worked, though. People still love it. So.
Yeah, it works. The anime is popular to 3-year-olds. Like, yeah, it works.
It's like it was targeting 3-year-olds.
And a few man-children, too.
I think you're a fucking fan.
I mean, I watched the Pokemon anime, and I enjoyed it when I was, like, 10 or 11 years old, so...
Yes, and you won't watch it now because it's shit. That's my point.
I think I don't think it's shit because the animals say their own names. I think it's shit because I think it's shit because
you were older?
I did. I think it's shitty because it's super tacky and like really lame. So that's also kind of why it's funny too
that
at the same time.
That is exactly what the whole saying their own name thing
but
does.
But I don't
it
think
helps with that 100%.
I don't think that the saying their own name thing really bothers me at all. I think it's the other aspects of it, just like the overly good natured, like, oh, and our friends continue on again, and like just the good nature of it.
Imagine if you wanted to, Patrick, imagine if you wanted to write a story about, like,
of course,
people and somehow living with, like, monsters or whatever, and would you have them saying their own name?
Of course not, but that's what it's like in the game.
Why
it's
not?
Okay.
But why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you have them saying their own name?
Because in my story, I could write it that they would just be fucking monsters, or I would say that they could just be fucking telepathic and solve all the problems and just talk to each other
in
our minds.
So why not just have them do something like that?
Because I think voice acting shitty animals is not a good idea when you've got 100 different animals to voice act. You got to think of animal noises for all 150 Pokemon or more.
Do you have to?
Well, hold on, then what is your solution? Because I thought you just offered a solution.
I didn't offer a solution. I'm saying that I don't mind that they say their own names because I don't know what else they would do that would really work.
I said if you were writing a movie, what would you do? You said something about telepathic.
Oh,
do that,
well, I guess...
You said you wouldn't make them say their own names, so then why is it a good idea for them?
It depends on the universe. For me, I would say, listen, for them to say their own names is kind of stupid, but an alternative Jay, I haven't been disagreeing with you necessarily.
I asked a question that was supposed to be analogous to the Pokemon universe. Was that not clear?
I'm saying I would make them telepathic so you could talk to them still. Because writing a story, but the problem is, in a Pokemon universe, if they're just animals though, and you can't actually talk to them, then I don't know what I would do. And
they're not just animals; they're monsters. This is why I use monsters as an example. So, are you saying you don't see a similarity when I'm asking you if you would write a story that's just like Pokemon? What would you have them do? And you're like, I wouldn't make them say their own name. That's what I'm trying to ask you.
Yeah, I wouldn't. But if it was going to be made into an anime, I don't know what I would do. That's what I'm saying. Because
So if you're going to make an anime where there's talking monsters, would you have them say their own name?
I might.
I'm not talking.
Sorry. I might.
But
I might.
Monsters.
Yeah.
You might.
I might. Because I understand that there'd be so many difficulties. And like, okay, well, then what the fuck are they going to do? If there's like 700 of them.
Why don't they just do what Digimon does? And just have them talk.
They could, if you wanted. Like, if
don't you
the
think
thing
it's
is
a much better choice.
Oh, I don't know if that.
I think I don't know about that because then you've got like 700 Pokemon.
So some of them talk. The ones that are just fucking birds just don't talk because they're a bird.
That's
there's birds and animals in cartoons.
That it just gets complicated.
They all double.
It's not complicated. The ones that are intelligent just talk. Like the psychic ones use telepathy. The ones that are just a fucking rat don't talk. They just don't make noises like that.
Interesting.
That's the way that makes sense. And then ones that are like man-shaped, I don't know, that one.
But then the ones that don't make noises, if they're a bear, I guess they just make a bear sound. But what if it's like a Mr. Mime and he can't talk? You'd just be like,
Well, Mr. Mime's psychic, so I wouldn't.
For example, a dragon or something will just roar all day long.
Listen. For 99% of these, the answer is obvious. If you want to ask about the 1% that's a little bit more complicated, we can talk about it. But obviously, there's some not too difficult solution out there. All I'm saying is that's leagues better than the idea of them just saying Machoke, and stupid shit like that. Like, come on.
I don't know. I don't think it's that bad.
Make noises.
What do you think?
You can't make them talk normal human voices. I'll completely ignore that.
Well, okay, so what are you saying? That they just have to say their own name? Like,
I like the idea of them talking in animal noises rather than their names.
What about you, Corey? What do you think?
Corey's not here.
I'm not suggesting they all talk. I'm just saying, I think they're... Oh, Corey is here. I'm saying there's better solutions. What is
Corey peanut butter?
What?
Corey's too busy eating peanut butter. It's fucking fun.
I don't know. Yeah, I think it's a little lame that they say their own name a million times.
Actually, I have an argument. I have an actual argument other than I just don't think it's good.
Okay.
Okay, so here's what I think. I think when in the realm of fiction, if you're like talking about writing fiction or creating fiction, I think, you know, you're always going to ask your audience to suspend their disbelief.
Yeah.
But I still feel like you have to try to make things kind of make sense to an extent. And I can't understand the logic leap of, well, they just say their own names. And that's what we call them. That, because to me, that doesn't make sense. It's like, logically, it makes zero sense. And I'm like, why don't we try to think of something that makes a little bit more sense? There are tons of other series that use aliens, monsters, whatever, and they don't fucking say their own name, you know?
I wonder if it's different because there's just so many of them, if that's why they chose that way.
I think that when they first started, they probably was like their first thing. They're like, okay, well, we're doing 150, but if this is popular, like, you have to have 720 something different voices now. That's insane.
Well, they wouldn't have first saw 700, but the thing is, what they knew is it was a show for kids, so they didn't need an idea that was like, yes, that's reasonable. I'm saying the aspects that make it like, oh, this clearly it's for, because it's for kids, and that's why it sucks. I'm saying that is what makes it less appealing to me. I'm saying I would like it more if it didn't do that.
Oh yeah, I see. Yeah, the anime itself also just is kind of shitty, and it was made to sell shit. Like, apparently, I guess Pokemon was just made to sell shit, because as soon as the anime started up in North America, there was shit on the shelves and everything for kids to buy right away, so they knew what they were doing.
That makes me wonder, something had to have come first. I wonder what exactly was that came first. What was the first thing they wanted to sell?
What I think is interesting would be like the fact that the investors had enough like certainty to give them enough money to like produce toys, games, like all this stuff, and then before they even released it, you know what I mean?
Well, I'm thinking the games came first, I'm not sure, and then the show was kind of made to sell the games, and they figured, well, if we're going to rely on a show to sell games, we might as well throw toys in, because that makes actually more sense than probably trying to sell the games or something. You know, I don't know. You always gotta take a leap. Like, I'm sure Transformers, the toys and the show probably came out at the same time, right? All it takes is one extra thing, and then it's like, well, that's a brave move.
As soon as you get your investors on board, then you can do anything you want. If they have trust, they've got trust. Oh shit! No, it's okay. Don't worry. As soon as your investors have faith in your product, then you can just like do whatever you want, and then you kind of fulfill your vision. What size is this bolt?
I don't know. It's always huge penis.
There it is. This fucking fly. Oh yeah, I gotta get a shower. My dirtiness is up.
What's the size of this bolt? Oh, this fucking fly. All right, I gotta get a shower.
Fucking dirty Canadians hanging out in other countries, dirtying them up.
Wait, it's not the same place.
Go back to your own country. Fucking cum ranks.
Oh my god.
What?
James.
James, we're recording. Everyone will see.
There's a weird physics glitch in this game. James?
You're done for now. Your career's over.
Yeah, I'm glad.
It's just like that, like anything you say, and like your whole life is just ruined.
That reminds me, you can get like banned off Twitch, right, if you show like certain things, like obviously nudity, or apparently guys can't have their shirt off either, and I think they just did that just to avoid any kind of inequality questions.
Yeah.
But there was a group of people playing together, and one of them was a girl, and they forgot they were recording, and she forgot her webcam was on, so she just started taking her shirt off, like, to change her shirts or something, I don't know. And then the guy was like, whatever your name is, what the fuck? And then they were like, oh shit, they all turned their webcams off.
That's good.
Yeah, I'm like, man, imagine getting banned for that. Like, I'm assuming they wouldn't give them, like, a long ban, but, like, that sucks.
Maybe, like, just try to be more careful next time.
That's, like, yeah, for a lot of people, though, that's their livelihood. Not being able to stream for a while, it's, like, they lose money then. Whoa.
Excuse me, Corey.
James, that's very rude.
I said, excuse me, Corey, what more do you want?
No, this game might have a lot of swimming in it, this Pokemon game, because it's islands. We'll see how it works.
I refuse to believe.
What? It's in Hawaii, James. This one's set in Hawaii.
I thought, okay, have they found a way to make swimming actually enjoyable, though?
Well, I don't know. I don't even know if there is a lot of swimming. They might just make you zoom past with a boat, you know? I don't know.
They got to fix the whole stupid HF system that nobody wants.
Yes! Actually, they have! And that's why I stay with the Pokemon series, because even though a lot of mechanics stay the same, they make things generally better. Gen 5 made it so that TMs were no longer single use. Like, you can find Earthquake to anyone you want. No more of this, well, I've got to start a new game if I want to get that TM. You know, like, that stuff sucks.
That did suck, didn't it?
No,
you
didn't.
Get, like, Aerial Ace from a gym, like, your fourth gym or something, maybe, but you feel like, I can't use this on my story Pokemon, because if I ever want to make, like, a Pokemon that's actually good, then I'll lose, I won't have the TM.
Yeah.
But no, that's not an issue anymore. And then it was either that generation or the next one. Anything in the main story did not require an HM to get past, except for maybe Surf at one instance or something, but even then I'm not sure. And then it was all for, like, after you're done the main mission and you're exploring to find good shit, like the Earthquake team.
I'm really glad they got rid of, like, Defog and Waterfall or whatever it was.
That's why Gen 4 gets a bad rap, by the way, because of it had more HMs than other generations.
I was going to ask about that, because Chuck Cornbury was playing that one. It's like, you hate a Flash run, that is fucking Defog.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the other reason it gets a bad rap, I believe, is one, I think it added the least amount of newest Pokemon for a new generation.
And also, Defog, it's like, unfortunately, kind of like Flash, Defog was literally useless in any other type, other time, so.
Which sucks. And the other reason it got a bad rap was, I believe, some people believe that the selection of Pokemon in the wild was bad. Like, for example...
Oh, like you don't find them in places?
Yeah. The only fire Pokemon aside from the starter, the monkey guy, is Ponyta. That's it.
Wait, in the whole game?
Yep, that's all you can get for fire
what?
Types.
What?
It's either in one of the versions or both the versions, but that's true.
Who? What?
What?
Doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
It's weird. Okay.
So I'm assuming some people also feel a bit upset about the lack, because that's the reason I think Black 2 and White 2 are way better than Black and White, are because they stopped with the stupid limit of only Gen 5 Pokemon in the main story, which I get why they did it, but I'm sorry, there's just not enough good options to make it as interesting. The fact that in Black 2 and White 2, you can get, like, a Riolu, which is Lucario's first evolution, and a Mareep in, like, the second route, like, that's awesome.
Oh,
those
yeah,
very
that's true.
Popular Pokemon. And I've always said that's one of the things they need to do, is they need to let you get a second save file so that you can start save a new save file without, like, losing Pokemon. And they need to make it so there's more Pokemon available at the beginning of the game. And a difficulty option, I guess.
Difficulty, like AI difficulty maybe, or like you have less, more, do they have more HP or something?
Whatever they can do. It would be nice if it was an AI difficulty, but if they could just, like, make it so that the standard deviation of levels...
Oh, true. Yeah, they just put the average level up in the whole game. That would be
good.
Well,
guess what? Black and White actually did offer a difficulty option, but you had to unlock it.
Oh, yeah. So, wait, wasn't it you had to, like, trade it between games, too, or something?
Yeah, and here's the thing. You can't use it on yourself. You can't use it on yourself.
That's
so
fucking
somebody,
stupid.
Somebody has to beat the game on normal to give it to everyone else on hard.
And wasn't it like
and
you
I
only
was
unlocked...
I was the one who was into it the most.
But then
so
it was
I
almost
rely
like...
on anyone else.
I could get hard mode from you, but you could only get easy mode from me or something like that?
Yes, yes. It's the other version.
What
is
the
hard
hell?
Mode with, like, black beat it or something.
So
like that,
stupid.
It is very stupid. But, like, they never had a difficulty option before, so I'm at least glad that, like, they're thinking about new things.
Mm-hmm.
I do think Pokemon Bank is good. Like, yes, it's a $5 a year service, but what you can just do is give them one $5, and then just never use it unless you want to use it again.
You know what?
And then what you can do, if you want to start a new game, just throw your Pokemon in the bank. Start the new game, throw them back in.
I thought it was pretty good, actually. I mean, because really, you're just paying for the servers, you know? So it's not like they're trying to make tons of money off you.
Yeah. Look, I'm using passports here so that I can avoid the question of gender to be less offensive.
Oh wait, do I put that on the back one or the front one?
But Patrick, do you play as the girl or the boy?
The girl, of course.
Yeah, I have a hard time choosing in a game like this. I think I typically prefer the boy in Pokemon, and I view it as myself.
See, I've somehow gotten past that, where I'm like, even though I'm not gay or anything,
you know,
I can still view it, play myself, even though I'm playing
as
a girl
gay,
character.
You're transgendered.
I'm just saying, I can roleplay while playing as a girl or a boy in that game. That's all.
You're transgendered. You can't roleplay everything, though, because you don't know what it's like to be a woman, so...
Of course, that's why I play as a lesbian woman.
You privileged white... That doesn't... Ah!
A lesbian tomboy woman.